Hey, you might get a bit distracted by my friends the umbrellas or possibly the sea. I'm in Bali. I'm just enjoying one of my many holidays these days. She says, that sounds a bit fancy, but basically I work crazy hard, as you probably know, for 10 years. And then I now choose to work 183 days a year, and I work really hard. And then I go on holiday for 182 days a year. Now, sometimes I do these amazing holidays like Bali, but sometimes I just spend time with people I love. So I could have been in Bali for longer. I wanted to come for like 3.5, 4 weeks, but I wanted to go up and see my parents too. So my beginning of my Balinese holiday was glamorous Glasgow. Hey, people I love. Okay, let's talk about how you can get on in property. Right, there are simple ones. They're buy to sell. Buy to sell, I want you to do 20% markup. I want you to make sure you've got 20% after all costs. And those costs, hun, are more than you think. I'm sorry, but it's true. They're the buying costs, the legal costs, the estate agency costs, the posing kit costs, although you can use them 5 times over. The gas, the electricity, the Wi-Fi, the council tax, the water rates, your accountancy costs, your finance costs, which will be your fees in, your fees out, and of course, very sadly, the interest that you have to pay as well. And then your cleaning costs and all your renovation costs, which either come individually or come as one. Typically for interest, if you're gonna use bridging, it's probably about, for every £100,000, it's about £8,000, just very roughly. And in the early days, you probably have to use bridging because you don't have enough money. It's annoying, but you know what? I'm grateful they're there because they get you to a place, but you don't necessarily wanna use them for the rest of your life. So that's your buy to sell. 20% markup after all costs. Safety helmet keeps you safe. Buy to let, honey. It is 10% yield. If you don't know what yield is, don't worry, neither did I. Gross yield is annual rent divided by purchase price. I keep it as simple as you possibly can. Why? Because I want to just be able to compare apples with apples with my properties. So annual rent divided by purchase price. And if you've been able to purchase it well, great. If you're in a big value city like London, then you're gonna have to get creative and really think this through. Because I want you to have 10% yield, and just because you're in London, so can you split it into two? Can you split the property into a number of units? Can you put one bed into a two bed, move in the kitchen into the living room and make in the kitchen the second bedroom? You know, can you make it into service accommodation with a combination of longer term corporate lets? Think this through, get 10% yield. And then finally, in the early days, look at your payback period, because you've run out of cash, you're out of the game. You're probably running profitable projects, you just ran out of cash, so you're out of the game. So, payback period is, how much profit does it make per month if it's a rental? How much money have I left in the property after I've refinanced? And how quickly can I pay myself back? And you need to kind of like swim and bridge the gap until that payback period is delivered for yourself. Those are my three criticals. They're markup for buy to sell, yield for buy to let, and then payback period, which keeps you in the game until you've gotten enough cash to not need the banks, which is where I'm at over 10 months, 10 years. Wouldn't it be lovely if it was 10 months, 10 years later? And then you choose what you do with your life, don't you? For me, I wanna spend time exploring the world. I mean, this is a big, old, amazing world. I also wanna spend time with my friends and family. A lot of time with friends and family. I like to do sport. You know, those are my choices that are meaningful to me. You will choose the choice that's meaningful to you. So good luck. The one thing I do not want to see happen is you not do it. You must do it. Oh, finally, YouTube, subscribe to my videos, okay? And then also go onto my website, thegoodpropertycompany.co.uk. I got tons of free stuff on there. I got checklists, I got 101 lessons, all that stuff. And then I got amazing pieces of education that are in-depth, detailed, written so that you can succeed. Good luck. So that's, thegoodpropertycompany.co.uk. Get yourself on there and have a right good scoop. See you soon. Bye.